Hey there, Aries. Welcome to reading for the week of August 17th. This week, if you want to catch me live, I go live every single day at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. All you have to do is subscribe, hit the bell notification icon, and I'm choking, and you will catch me live. But Aries, let's see what is going on for you here. And Aries, this week, very quick movement coming in for you. Definitely could be a wish coming in for you as well, right off the bat, but let's keep going here. I feel like you're having to think about something, or you're potentially having to think about making a decision based off of what will make you happy. Ten of Cups right here. So this looks very interesting, but let's dig into this here, Aries. As always, we're going to clarify in just a couple minutes with the Lenormand, but you start off with the Vulture Spirit. This card says nothing is wasted. The Vulture Spirit kind of represents vultures, obviously, and vultures are masters of conservation of energy. So I feel like for some of you that this could say that maybe you have spent a lot of time on something here in this first row. So I feel like maybe you have invested a lot of time in a relationship, or in future relationships, I feel like you're going to be saying to yourself, like, you know, what is the most amount of energy I should invest in this to figure out if it's worth it or not? I don't think this is a bad thing. I don't think you're doing this like a nerdy little scientist, right? I don't think you're doing this, I just feel like you just don't want to waste your time. And again, I also feel like maybe you really put your heart and soul into relationships, for example, or whatever it is you're working on. And I just feel like you want to kind of know upfront. It's like, I feel like you want to cut your losses with this Ace of Swords. We're going to talk about this in a second, but it's like you want to cut your losses before you get to the point where you're going to get hurt. Or, you know, if this is in business as well, Aries, you know, it's like you want to make sure that if you're putting your time, effort, and energy in a job or a business, that you're actually getting paid your worth. I'm really surprised that the Six of Pentacles didn't show up here, because, you know, normally I actually don't like the Six of Pentacles in love situations for the most part. But what I will say is that to me, this is more general in your life, that you're just saying you don't want to waste your time on anything, Aries, this whole reading. And, you know, in relationships, it's kind of like, I feel like you're trying to figure out, like, you know, what, you know, how will I know if I should invest or not sooner? And it's because you don't want to waste time, which I totally understand, Aries, right? I don't think there's anything wrong with that. In this row here, you have the Eight of Wands, the Nine of Cups, and the Nine of Wands here. The Nine of Wands is like a little bit of defensive energy, but I really feel like this Nine of Cups and the Nine of Wands are more just saying that you are perfectly fine on your own. And I feel like maybe some of you have truly you've finally gotten to that stage in life where you are satisfied on your own. It's like the Death card in the Ten of Cups you have here in this last row, it's almost like they're saying, you know, it would be nice to be in a committed relationship. Maybe it would be nice to be with someone who really wants to invest time, effort, and energy with you. But I feel like you're truly kind of getting to this place here where you're fine on your own. The Eight of Wands is like quick success, but I feel like it's more knowing what you want. And really, that's what I feel like this whole first row here is saying for you, Aries. I feel like it's just saying that you understand what you want. You understand your true desires. The Eight of Wands is like the arrows of love. You know, it's like these are the, and it's also the arrows of manifestation as well. It is you kind of firing your rockets of desire, as Esther Hicks says, into the universe. It's like, you know what you truly want, which is great. It's like, once we know exactly what we want, Ace of Swords, once we're clear on our true desires, that's when we get everything we want. For some of you, I feel like there could be a move here as well. We'll talk about that at the end. In this middle row here, look, you have this Illumination card here, Aries, and you have this Happiness card. Plain and simple, like I said in this first row, I feel like you just understand what is going to make you happy. It's like you understand what your fulfillment is with this Nine of Cups. Look, you go from the Nine of Cups here to the Ten of Cups. It's like you're moving towards total fulfillment and contentment. To me, the Ten of Cups is better. Nine of Cups is good. You know, it's like a card of wishes. It's a card of satisfaction. It's a card of being happy. But that Ten of Cups is just like, just that little bit extra. I mean, it's like the Nine of Cups, it's good. It would be like a sundae, but you know, the Ten of Cups is like a sundae with the cherry on top here, or whatever toppings you want, right? The, you know, if you're asking me, this is like, you know, that with extra cookie dough, you know, on your ice cream or whatever. So this is like just that little bit extra that is coming into your life here with that Ten of Cups. I feel like it's like you understand what is going to bring you happiness in relationships and other areas of your life as well. In this middle row, you have the Four of Swords, the Ace of Swords, and the Four of Cups. I feel like you have taught yourself to pause here. That's like the first thing that pops into my head here with this reading. It's almost like you've taught yourself how to pause before you get into a relationship or invest your heart and soul into something. So I feel for some of you, you just have taught yourself to kind of like be like, okay, I know I normally get excited at the beginning of these relationships, so now I just need to slow it down and just kind of make sure this is something I want to invest in. So like I said, I feel like you're just slowing things down here in this row. For others, I do feel like this could be a legal victory for some reason. I feel like this is kind of like a side message. If you're dealing with something legal, I feel like this could be like a settlement offer with this Four of Cups, but it's not quite right. I feel like there's something, it's not like enough. For others, this could be a work offer, and same thing. I feel like some of you could be getting a work offer this week, but there's just something missing here. So I feel like some of you in those situations might wait, and they're just popping into my head as well. For others of you, like I said, I feel like you know the truth now about what you want to avoid. Devil card here. It's like you know the truth about what you're willing to accept in relationships. And the Ace of Swords is saying you're only willing to accept a victory. So, I mean, I feel like your reading is very simple, as always, Aries. I feel like your reading is just saying you're only willing to accept a victory. I also get something about learning here as well. And again, just a side message. I read intuitively. And just intuitively, I feel like some of you could be learning something. And if you're like going to school, or if you're training, or if you're just teaching yourself something here, Aries, I feel like there could be a lot of success, financial success coming in for you based off of something you're learning. And I feel like I've said that to you before. I just feel like there could be a lot of financial success coming in for you from something you're learning. So love it. That's amazing. Next, you have this Truth Be Told card here. There is some sort of thing about like honesty here showing up in your reading. You have the Ace of Swords here. I really don't think this is someone telling you the truth, is what I'd say to you, Aries. I feel like this is you telling yourself the truth. I feel like you are just clear. Like I said, you have this Illumination card here in this middle row. I feel like you're just very clear on what you want. In this row here, you have the Death card, the Ten of Cups, and the Devil. It's like you're letting go of the past with that Death card. I feel like people cause too many fears, too many fantasies, too many illusions. I feel like maybe some of you have been in relationships where it's like the person would paint this picture of the future, and they would tell you how wonderful it's going to be, and like all these things you would do together. And you get very excited, and then it's like you'd realize this person is the devil with this Devil card. Or you'd realize that it was all just a fantasy, you know, that it wasn't real. So I feel like you're very focused on something real. You know, the sun is rising on the Death card here, and it's coming up between the two pillars that are on the Moon card. And so it kind of says that you have gone through this period of fear, illusions, things not being very clear, or just straight up lies from people. And it's like, now you're stepping into the truth. The sun is rising on this card here. And it's like, look at how he's sitting. You know, the skeleton, if you can see it on the camera, it's like he's sitting on this horse. It's like, it's almost like these people are begging this person, the skeleton, to, you know, see things their way. But it's like, I feel like you have gained some wisdom here, Aries. It's like you only see things the right way now. I feel like you see the truth is what this is saying. I feel like it doesn't matter what people beg or what they say or anything like that. You have the Ten of Cups and the Devil here. Again, I feel like there's fortune after, Ten of Cups is fortune after difficulty, good things coming in for you after a difficult period of time. So definitely could be love coming in here. The Devil, I feel like you're just saying you're just avoiding toxic people. You know, again, in this row here, it's like you go from the Eight of Wands to the Ace of Swords to the Devil. It's like you're being very cut and dry, very straight and to the point. It's you're not willing to accept this type of energy here. I also feel like this is like, I feel like one of your warning signs, Aries, in relationships is going to be like people holding on to you too tightly. It's almost like you know that if people try to, like, you know, lock you down too soon, I feel like that's a warning sign for you with this Devil card. So that's what I'd say here. But yeah, this looks very interesting. Like I said, for others in work or business, I feel like you're just very, very it's like you're getting very clear up front about expectations in work or business. And I feel like this is so you don't waste time. And I feel like that's going to be very good for you here. You're really going for what you want here, Aries. So I like that. But let's clarify. Between the Eight of Wands and the Four of Swords here, yeah, you have the Snake. This is the Queen of Clubs. It's a card of seduction, but like I said, the Four of Swords, like saying you're taking a pause, and it's like you're seeing things not how you want to see them with this last row here. I feel like you're seeing things as they truly are. Again, I feel like maybe in the past, you would get into situations where people would tell you all these great things that would happen in the relationship, and maybe they just didn't happen, or maybe it was lies, right? And I feel like you're just taking a pause before you rush into anything, and you're saying, like, is this person just a BS artist, or is this, like, you know, something real? Between the Nine of Cups and the Ace of Swords, major victories. You have the Star card here. This is the Six of Hearts. The Star in the Lenormand is like hope, wishes, dreams, you know, good things coming in for you. It's also removal of obstacles. Like I said, it's almost like you're taking your time and you're saying, are there going to be obstacles in this situation I'm dealing with before I even get started? You know, it's like there is this theory in life that some, you know, people have, right? Where it's like we should just only double down on things that work, right? It's like, imagine if we all just kind of focused on our strengths instead of our weaknesses, or imagine if we just got into relationships with people who were actually legitimate, which can be hard to tell sometimes, but it's like if we got into these relationships where people, you know, where it wasn't like this power struggle, you know, I feel like you're just looking for things that just work, and that's what you're focusing on. Now, between the Nine of Wands and the Four of Cups, you have the Five of Spades. Yeah, cutting out the crap. Again, Five of Spades is a breakup card. It's not a real Lenormand card. This deck that I'm using has some extra cards in it, but it is a card of cutting out the crap. I feel like you're just cutting out things that no longer serve you. Between the Four of Swords here and the Death card, yeah, Five of Diamonds. Five of Diamonds is my Just Do It card, but it's also a card of success and abundance. Like I said, I do feel like some of you could have like some sort of settlement. The Five of Diamonds in the playing card reading system can represent a settlement or receiving a settlement. So I do feel like this could be some sort of financial settlement coming in for you here, Aries. I also just feel like it's new beginnings. Again, like the sun is coming up on that death card. Between the Ace of Swords here and the Ten of Cups, you have the Jack of Diamonds. This is called the Scythe. Like I said, cutting out the crap. This card literally represents cutting things out of your life. It is a card of anxiety or feeling anxiety. You know what this could be? This can be one of those situations where you start making decisions for yourself here, Aries, and people don't like it. You know, it's like one of those things where sometimes we start making decisions for ourselves, and all the, it's like we see people's true colors. I feel like with this Ten of Cups, it's like you're really truly seeing at this time who's for you and who's against you. And so I feel like you're really focused, and I feel this is a good thing. It's like you're seeing the truth and you're saying to yourself, you know what, I'm just gonna put my time, effort, and energy into those people who are for me in love and business, all areas of my life, and that's it. Between the Four of Cups here and the Devil, you have the Three of Spades. Yep, like I said, Three of Spades is a card of breakups. You're breaking up with the Devil here, or you're just totally avoiding Devil energy, abusive, toxic energy completely altogether. In your top row outcome here, you have the Seven of Diamonds. This card is called the Birds, and it just represents communication. It's also a card of intuition, so definitely trust your intuition this week. I do feel like some of you, if you're looking for love, could be getting communication from someone new with the Jack of Diamonds here. It could be an earth sign. It could also, some of you could be Capricorn or Scorpio is also popping out here. This is just a general reading. It could be any sign here. In your middle row, you have the Seven of Spades. Definitely communication coming in for you here. I really didn't feel that with the Ace of Swords. But you do have the Eight of Wands and the Ace of Swords. As I always say, I mean, I put this all together at the end anyway, but so, you know, obviously I see it now, but I do feel like this could be communication for some of you here, but I feel like you're pausing the communication. It's like you're really making sure with that Four of Swords that it's legitimate. In your bottom row outcome, you have the King of Spades. Yeah, this is what you're looking for in love here. If you're looking for love, the King of Spades is a card of maturity. It's a card of someone who comes in with a legitimate offer. This card is called the Lily, and it kind of represents someone giving you a flower, right? In some ways. That's actually not accurate, Lenormand, but that's what's popping into my head. I feel like you're just more focused on legitimate offers. Even this Jack of Diamonds here, this Scythe card, it can kind of represent a little bit of immaturity. So it's like you're going from immature energy to very mature energy. So I feel like you're just very focused on something that's mature. It's like you're moving away from these liars, cheaters, stealers, storytellers, all this other type of energy here. So it's like you want something legitimate. I definitely feel like there could be important communication coming in for you this week here, Aries. And again, it could be in love. I would say probably not this week, having said that, because this is your future position here. And so I feel like for some of you, maybe this week, you're just focused on a pause, making sure everything that's coming into your life is legitimate. It actually looks like a really nice week. Again, really good cards here. Eight of Wands, quick success. Some of you could be moving or traveling with the Eight of Wands and that Ace of Swords. You could be planning this for the future as well. That Death card going through major positive transformations as well in your life. So I like to see that. With this this Six of Hearts, the Star card, and this Death card, for some of you, this could be a turnaround. The Six of Hearts is kind of a card that says obstacles are being removed from your life. So I feel like some of you could be avoiding certain obstacles as well. But this looks really nice for you, Aries. So I like this. I don't know. There's nothing really else jumping out at me. I feel like you're just focused on your own happiness, which is nice as well. But love it. So thank you for watching, Aries, and definitely enjoy your week.